Google just dropped a preview of Nano Banana 2 on media.io, and the image quality is absolutely mind-blowing. This could legitimately be the most impressive AI image generator we've seen to date, and it's not even officially launched yet. So here's what's happening. Nano Banana is Google's lightweight image generation model designed to run fast without compromising on visual quality. Think of it as their small but powerful option for quick, high-end generations on regular devices. And this Nano Banana 2 preview is taking things to a completely different level. The detail, the sharpness, the consistency across different styles, it's all dramatically improved from what we had before. Now, if you want to test this out yourself, you'll need to go through media.io. They somehow got early access to the endpoint, possibly through some partnership with Google. I'd never used this platform before, but they're currently the only place hosting this preview model. You'll need to navigate to their text-to-image section and select the Nano Banana option from the model dropdown. Here's the catch, though. You need a paid plan to access it. They do offer a 3-day free trial, which is what I used to test this out. But fair warning, if you forget to cancel before those 3 days are up, you're looking at $167 for the annual subscription. Honestly, I'd say just wait for the official release unless you're desperate to try it now. The risk of forgetting to cancel isn't worth it. Right now, there's also a ton of traffic hitting this preview. You'll probably run into algorithm errors and failed generations because so many people are trying to access it simultaneously. But when it does work, the results are genuinely shocking. Let me show you what this thing can actually do. There's this example where someone took a car image and prompted the model to move it into a white room with a concrete floor, keeping the car in the exact same position on a circular platform. And Nano Banana 2 nailed it. It preserved every detail of the car, the exact angle, the lighting characteristics, everything, while completely transforming the background. This kind of precise control with that level of quality is seriously impressive, especially at the speed it generates. According to leaks circulating in the developer community, the official launch is scheduled for November 15th. Google's targeting native 2K output with potential 4K upsampling capabilities right from day one. We're also hearing whispers about Gemini 3.0 dropping the same week, possibly around the 21st or later in the month. The improvements they're promising are substantial. We're talking major upgrades in text rendering, which has historically been a massive pain point for image generation models. Better handling of infographics and charts, improved world knowledge, all those tricky elements that usually break or look completely wrong. The reason for this jump in quality comes down to the foundation. Nano Banana 2 is built on the new Gemini 3.0 Pro image backbone, which is a massive leap forward from the old 2.5 flash model. Media.io's preview already shows expanded aspect ratio options, everything from standard formats all the way up to ultra-wide 21:9. There's also code suggesting new output modes including 1K, 2K, and 4K options. If all of this actually ships, we're looking at a completely new tier of creative control for AI image generation. But here's where things get really interesting. Internal testing and GitHub activity are hinting that Google might rebrand this as Nano Banana Pro, and the performance improvements look absolutely massive. We're seeing reports of 3 times better instruction following compared to the previous version. Way more consistency than early Nano Banana 2 builds. The model's even passing stress tests, like reconstructing shredded images, which is wild to think about. There's debate in the community right now about what's actually powering this. Is Nano Banana 2, or GemPix 2 as it's called internally, running on Image Gen 4? Or is it still using Gemini 3 Pro or Flash like the first Nano Banana? There are mentions of multiple variants including a high-res Nano Banana Pro model, but nothing's officially confirmed. What we do know is internal testing has started, and announcement cards are already appearing in the Gemini UI, which typically means a public rollout is just days away. The photorealism is legitimately shocking. There's this image of what looks like an official document or certificate. At first glance, it looks completely real. But if you actually read the text carefully, you'll notice inconsistencies, weird dates, nonsensical words. It's AI generated, but your brain doesn't register that immediately. That's how convincing the overall composition is. Let me show you a direct comparison that really drives home the improvement. Someone prompted both Nano Banana 1 and 2 to generate a Minecraft clone. The first version created something that looks decent on the surface, but the GUI doesn't match Minecraft at all. The mobs don't look right. The whole thing just feels off if you actually know what Minecraft looks like. But the Nano Banana 2 version? Everything's accurate. The interface, the blocks, the overall aesthetic, it all matches what you'd expect from an actual Minecraft screenshot. That level of accuracy in understanding and recreating a specific visual style is exactly what separates good image models from great ones. The fact that Google's pushing this hard into on-device lightweight generation while maintaining this quality level is significant. We've typically had to choose between speed and quality, between running something locally or getting the best results from cloud-based models. If Nano Banana 2 delivers on what this preview is showing, that compromise might not exist anymore. This is genuinely one of the most exciting image generation releases in recent memory. The combination of speed, quality, and control we're seeing here could completely reshape how people think about AI image tools. Keep an eye out for that November 15th launch, because if Google ships even half of what we're seeing in this preview, the entire landscape of AI image generation is about to shift dramatically. The future of creative AI tools is looking absolutely incredible right now, and we're just getting started. All right, that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and catch you in the next one.